West of the city of Bend in Oregon is a towering active volcano whose highly symmetrical edifice is currently the site of a ski resort. Known as Mount Bachelor, this fascinating volcano is younger than it looks and may one day erupt again. For example, its most recent eruption began around 6000 BCE, forming the 560-foot-tall Egan cinder cone, an event which covered 3.6 square miles in lava and started forest fires. While the towering peak of Mount Bachelor is by far the most voluminous feature, being a young stratovolcano built on top of a young shield volcano, it is not the only part of this volcanic complex, as the Mount Bachelor volcano also consists of a second shield volcano, more than a dozen cinder cones, and the remnants of a volcanic eruption which occurred underneath a thick ice sheet. Altogether, this cluster of recent volcanism covers an area of 135 square miles or 350 square kilometers, with all 50 of its vents forming between 18,000 and 8,000 years ago. The vast majority of these vents are spread out across a 15.5-mile or 25-kilometer-long lineament which seemingly represents where magma from the subducting Juan de Fuca plate somewhat evenly rose. Approximately 18,000 years ago, a 1,500-foot-thick glacier existed along the majority of Oregon's Cascade mountain range. It is in the eastern section of this zone where glaciers existed further east than the rest of the mountain range due to the presence of the broken top volcano that magma began intruding into the crust. This formed a northward-trending dike 1 mile in length which, upon reaching the bottom of the glacier, produced a layer of pillow basalt which is more commonly found at deep submarine volcanoes. As three vents formed, they began to explosively interact with the glacial ice above, creating heavy ash emissions to produce a material known as hyaloclastite. But before these subglacial cinder cones could reach the surface of the subglacial lake they created, the eruption ended. It would be another 1,000 years before the second eruption occurred, but this time at a location 4 miles to the south. With no glaciers present overlying this patch of ground, a similar dike created a chain of 5 small cinder cones, the northwesternmost of which was the dominant vent. As intermittent explosions of ash occurred, several hundred-foot-high lava fountains were generated, propelled upwards by expanding gases. During the next 5 weeks, basaltic lava expanded outwards in all directions, dividing a larger lake into the Elk Lake and Lava Lakes. With 1.8 square miles covered in fresh lava, the eruption ended. The next eruption occurred 6.5 miles to the southeast, producing the beginnings of a small shield volcano. Several eruptions occurred over the next 1,000 years, building Sheridan Mountain. Between 14,000 and 12,000 years ago, more than a dozen separate eruptions formed scattered cinder cones, some of which erupted on top of Sheridan Mountain. Eruptive activity later moved further northwards and formed the Coal Butte Shield Volcano, which acted as a base that Mount Bachelor would grow on top of. Mount Bachelor proper formed due to more than a dozen eruptions between 12,000 and 10,000 years ago, depositing ash near its summit and sending lava flows down its flanks. At one point, a fairly thick glacier developed on its summit, and as it advanced, it pulverized some of the basaltic andesite lava rocks into finely green dust. After a 2,000-year hiatus, marking Bachelor's longest pause to date, the medium-sized Egan cone formed in a mildly explosive eruption 1.5 miles to the north around 6,000 BCE. Since Mount Bachelor has not erupted since and has not shown any signs of life in recent years, there is a possibility that it will never erupt again. But if it were to erupt again, a cinder cone forming eruption north of its central peak would be the most likely outcome, sending lava flows up to 20 kilometers away and heavy ash emissions as far as 10 kilometers away. Since these ash emissions could disrupt regional air traffic and there are residences within this radius, the U.S. Geological Survey designated Mount Bachelor as a moderate threat volcano. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.